impartial.
That's right. Now, Alyssa, to the point of what John's referencing here, of course, these documents were discovered back in November, about a week before the midterm elections. They called the National Archives, but they didn't disclose it. Okay, and that does raise questions about the political timing. I mean, let's just call it like it is. Mm-hmm.
I mean, listen, this is a gift to the Trump camp. The people I'm hearing from who are still in Trump world are saying this basically makes our case for us. He was standing by politics by not becoming transparent and coming right out with this. But also it speaks to the case that they've tried to make, which is prior presidents have mishandled classified information, or in this case, a vice president. That said, the worst possible outcome for the country would be if the takeaway from this is we lower the penalty for mishandling classified information. It should be depoliticized, to John's point. The facts need to play out. There's a lot of unknowns here, and we just need to see where this goes. The two cases are apples and oranges, but in a politically divided time, each side's going to hear what they want to it.
Right, and as you say, apples and oranges, and that's important to draw the distinction and the nuance, but to say that just because this may have been accidental and they cooperated, there's nothing, let's just move along here, wouldn't be right either. Mayor Rawlings-Blake, you know, the Attorney General obviously assigned the U.S. Attorney in Chicago to this holdover from the Trump administration, did so to be completely impartial, right? Look who I'm putting in charge of it. So where do you think we are in that?
All I can say is when I first saw the news, I mean, the Democrats had just